In 2005, the Constitutional Reform Act said there should be a separate and distinct Supreme Court, separate from Parliament. And in 2009, this court became operational. We have 12 justices, and between them they hear around about 90 Supreme Court cases a year, and then another 40 or 50 come from the Judicial Committee of the Privy Council. So about 130, 140 cases a year. The reason we added live streaming and media coverage was because the justices themselves wanted it to be open, visible, accessible. Because when they reach a decision here, that decision is then binding on all lower courts, so it affects everybody. We've always had cameras in the courtroom since 2009, and then we started live streaming the following year, 2010. And gradually, year on year, the number of people that sort of log on and watch what goes on has increased. The equipment that we had was reaching end of life. It was 10 years old. It wasn't able to broadcast in HD format and was starting to look a bit tired. We had to replace it. So that's when we started looking around for, okay, what do we want to replace it with? And it had to be something which, from the viewer's point of view, gave the best experience. They could see things, they could hear things clearly. From our point of view, it had to be something which was cost effective and was easy for our broadcast engineers to operate.
We're in a situation where we were forced to go IP for this broadcast upgrade project due to the limitations we have, as this is a listed building. We couldn't run new cabling from the existing courtrooms back to the broadcast gallery. So the only way we could actually do that is to tie up with our IP infrastructure through our own internal network. Go through NDI and utilize IP. This is the way that broadcasting is going. When we first initiated contact with NewTek, we were given a lot of support right from the beginning through the regional sales manager and through their technical support. All our court cases are recorded, archived, and streamed on a website. Various media outlets also have access to our feed so they can broadcast it. In the courtroom, each courtroom has 4 PTZ cameras. That feed goes to a broadcast gallery where the operators mix it, record, and to output to the streaming platform so users can navigate to a website and watch the live proceedings. We have 3 TC1s, and because everything is IP, all the cameras are available to connect to instantly, so there is no downtime. Every case is recorded, every case is live streamed, and also available to watch on demand after the fact through our website. This gives us flexibility, which we didn't have before, and we needed a system that is future-proofed. And the system is constantly updated through software updates. So this system really appealed to us because it's a system that can be built upon.
In the first test, it was slightly thrust upon us. We had the recent Brexit cases, and it meant that we had to get things done far sooner than we'd anticipated. And that was the first real test of the equipment. I would have preferred a sort of slightly less high profile case to test it on, but having said that, it worked and worked very well. We had a lot of people in the building for those 3 days, both public, press, lawyers, and we got a lot of feedback, particularly from the media and the public, who said the broadcast quality was really noticeably good and clear.
The feedback that we've got from our operators is that it is a really good system, even through implementation, really simple to set up.
We had a record number of people logging onto our website to watch the live streaming. I think at one stage it was 4.8 million, which for us was very high. There were other people watching via news outlets, but what number, I don't know. But it stood up and stood up really well. We've had nothing but positive feedback so far.